Now we're going to take a look at raising radicals to powers. As long as we remember that an exponent tells us how many factors we're multiplying together, this will be just like multiplying radicals, which we've already done. However, in the process, we are going to notice a shortcut. So square root 6 squared is equal to square root 6 times square root 6. And this product would be equal to the square root of 6 times 6, which is a perfect square. Therefore, this simplifies to just one factor of 6. Notice when we square a square root, they undo each other, leaving us with the radicand. Next, we have 2 square root 3 squared. So again, this is going to be equal to 2 square root 3 times 2 square root 3. And then to find this product, we multiply the coefficients together. 2 times 2 is equal to 4. And then we multiply the radicands together, which would be the square root of 3 times 3, which again, notice is a perfect square. So this simplifies. We'd have 4 times 3, which is equal to 12. So the shortcut here would have been to square 2 to get the 4, and then when we square the square root of 3, that's equal to 3. Therefore, the product is 12. Next, we have the cube root of 4 raised to the third power. So we have 3 factors of the cube root of 4. And so this product would be equal to the cube root of 4 times 4 times 4, which again is a perfect cube. So this simplifies to one factor of 4. Notice how if we cube a cube root, they undo each other, leaving us with the radicand. So whenever we raise a radical to the power of the index, it will simplify to just the radicand. Let's look at one more example where the expression doesn't simplify perfectly. Here we have the square root of 3 raised to the third power. So we have 3 factors of the square root of 3. So we'll have the square root of 3 times 3 times 3. But because this is a square root, we're looking for perfect square factors, or groups of 2 equal factors. So 3 times 3 or 9 is a perfect square. So this simplifies, but this 3 here doesn't. So this simplifies to a factor of 3 from this group outside the square root, and then we still have square root 3 from this factor here. I hope you found this helpful.